stands besides India in its battle against terror.
On September 4, Pakistani terrorists crossed the line of control and martyred 18 Indian soldiers. With me is the Bangladeshi High Commissioner in New Delhi. So your reaction to this heinous incident?
My Prime Minister, in a message to Prime Minister Narendra Modi, has condemned this act of terrorism in strongest terms, and she has said Bangladesh opposes terrorism in all its forms and manifestations. And in pursuance of our zero tolerance policy towards terrorism, she has said that Bangladesh will be cooperating with India in this battle against terrorism.
Sir, do you think it's time to isolate those who have been sponsoring terrorism as its state policy?
We will be discussing all this issue in New York, and along with other countries, we will take every possible diplomatic action to condemn and isolate the perpetrators of such terrorism.
So the SAARC summit is going to happen in Islamabad later this year. Any decision regarding the representation of Bangladesh there?
Well, as you know, even before your 18th of September, there were two preparatory meetings which were held of the SAARC. One of them was the SAARC Home Minister's Conference, which was attended by the Indian Home Minister, but our Home Minister did not go. We were represented by senior officials. Likewise, there was another meeting of SAARC finance ministers, which took place, I think, a month ago. And at that meeting also, Bangladesh was not represented at the ministerial level. But no decision has so far been taken who would represent us at the forthcoming SAARC summit in Islamabad. But as I said earlier, there will be ample opportunity for us to discuss with the Indian leadership also at the Goa.
So clearly the world has united and supporting India at a time when the country has suffered from one of the worst terror attacks in recent months. With camera person Anil Khanna, Siddhant Sibal, DD News, New Delhi.
In an exclusive conversation with Doordarshan News, Afghan Ambassador Dr. Shahida Abdali has said that India and Afghanistan should take a lead in isolating the sponsors of terror. Condemning the Uri terror attack, the ambassador said a common definition of terrorism is needed.
With me is Afghanistan's ambassador to India, Dr. Shahida Abdali. Sir, your first reaction to the heinous incident which has taken place?
It was a very tragic incident where we lost 18 of brave Indian soldiers in the recent attack. Afghanistan condemns it in the strongest possible terms and express our condolences to the people of India and the families of the victims.
Mm-hmm. Sir, India has been calling for isolation of Pakistan, who has been providing safe havens to terrorists. Will Afghanistan join this entire alliance?
There must be an effort at the regional and a global level. Mm-hmm. We shouldn't be only seeking ourselves along this. Mm-hmm. For ourselves, this is a global issue. Countries of this region all must unite and isolate whoever is sponsoring to terrorism to other countries. Mm-hmm.
Sir, India has been looking forward for economic sanctions. Afghanistan join for economic sanctions?
Unfortunately, in the last 15 years, we are dealing with this problem of terrorism tactically. Mm. And we have been reactive so far. Mm. Reactionary measures against terrorism will never work. Mm. Therefore, the entire mechanism of counter-terrorism at the global level has to be revisited.
Mm-hmm. So clearly, the world uniting against this scourge of terrorism, and hopefully a solution will be out very soon. With camera person Anand Prakash, Siddhant Sibal, DD News at the Afghan Embassy in New Delhi.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi.